I wonder if somebody will throw a bomb at me, you know. I wonder if I go to this shopping center, it will be going pieces. So you're always kind of afraid. Do you know why you're afraid? Because there is still some kind of remains of fear. And you're wondering, why, God, why didn't you took them out? Well, God cannot take them out because God already gave you a weapon that you should use, but you don't use it. Do you know what is the weapon? It's the love of God. And you don't use it. Because we develop in anything else, in preaching skills, in organizational skills, in torturing skills. You know, we torture people with the Bible, you know, when they come to meetings. Instead of them being built up, we torture them. So now they feel more guilty from when they came. They go out, they're guilty. They're guilty, they're condemned. So we torture them, especially with preachers. We torture them all the time. Oh, you should be a better person. And he's trying his best and he cannot become a better person. If you could have become a better person, you didn't need a Jesus. Amen. You don't need Jesus. You know, if you wanted to become a better person on your own, you don't need salvation. You don't need the Holy Spirit. You don't need anything of that. But because you cannot become a better person, because you cannot become better, you need the Holy Spirit. Because it's in Him. It's the fruit. It's the fruits. You know, in Galatians 5:22, it says the fruit of the Spirit is love and then joy, patience. Well, you cannot develop those. They are already in the Spirit. What you need to do is you need to enter them. Anyway, so does this make sense?
Yes.
Is this okay?
Yes.
This is just the introduction. Okay, so so if you cannot understand, listen, if you cannot understand that you are loved by God, if you cannot accept that, you will always be afraid. And it doesn't matter if I come and say, be courageous, be bold. It will not work for you. It will work, it's almost like a, it will work for today. And it will work for 5 days. And it's like adrenaline. Oh, I feel very good. Like. But then after 5 days, you walk in your fields of your work or your mission or whatever you do, and suddenly you feel fear. And you're thinking like, but why I didn't feel that fear there? Well, you didn't feel that fear there because the adrenaline kicked you and you felt that something of the presence of maybe the one who is preaching or the whole gathering, and that fear was kind of like covered. But now suddenly you feel the fear again. Why? Because you have never learned, or you're not learning, that you need to learn the love of God. Listen, there is a verse in the Bible where it says, and all the promises, as many they are yes and amen for those who are in Christ. Now, if you don't believe that God loves you, you might take 2-3 promises of those and you will reject all the others. Why? Because you will say, well, God does not love me so much to give me all the promises. He loves me this much. And I can believe for that, but for the rest, no, I cannot believe. But that's not what that verse says. It says all the promises. Now, does all means all in your language? Like when you say all, is it like, if you have from 1 to 100, is it 88? Is it 56? Or it's 100? But I'm not a good mathematician, but what does it mean? Is it means all? Like all?
Yeah.
And you're sure it means all? All the promises. Wow. I'm not sure that everybody believes that it's all promises. I think that they believe just few promises. But they leave the others. And thus we have a problem. Because you don't believe that God loves you. You don't believe that you're really, really, really loved. And because you don't believe that He really loves you, you're afraid. Because it says, it's the perfect love which casts out all fears. And actually it says, when you perfect yourself into the love, when you grow into the love, when you mature yourself into the understanding of love, fears will go away. I don't know if I will scare you. I guess everybody is above 18 here, but I will tell you 2 stories, which might be scary for you, but just bear with me, okay? My wife was praising God this night, one night, this is like almost like one year ago, and she was praising God because she got a revelation. She just got a revelation.